Hey guys, it's Danielle. In this part, we will add a weapon to our character and animate an attack animation. We will also create a sword holding animation to be combined with our idle and walk animations by code. If you are new to this tutorial series, be sure to check out the first three parts where we created the character's PSD file, its rigging, and its walk and idle animations. A reminder, a link for both the PSD file and the spine file is in the description below. Off camera, I created this sword attachment. I choose to create a sword only from the front view. But if you are looking for a more realistic approach, I recommend creating 5 different attachments for this sword, specific for each direction. To add a sword to our spine file, place the PNG file inside the images folder. In the spine project, click on Images, refresh to see the sword image. Dragging this image to the setup mode will create a slot for the sword. As this character is going to hold the sword with its hand, I created a new bone for the sword and placed it under the left hand. We are animating a jumping attack. The character will swing the sword and bend it against a lower enemy on the ground. The animation starts with one of the legs up in the air and a hand swinging the sword back. Next comes the bending forward and the jump while holding the sword with both hands. Once the sword hits the ground, we land. We copy the animation to create other directions, using the direction bank to rearrange the bones and switch to the relevant directions attachments. I found that swinging the swords from the side looks nice, and I use it in all the directions. This animation will need some VFX, like a smudge for the sword, but I will save that for another time. To create the hold animation, we are going to use track overriding. We will create an animation with the relevant keyframes for the holding action, and override it with either the walk or the idle animations. It is important to make sure the holding animation contains only the keyframes we use for the holding. Any other random keyframes may override something important in the idle or the walk animation. We use the tracks at the preview window to see how our animations are overriding. The upper layer will override the bottom layer. So we select the hold animation for track 1 and the idle or walk animation for track 0. And that's it, we are ready to move to our game engine. That's the end of the first part of the 8 direction tutorial series. The next part is a bonus video, where we will create a script to integrate Spine with Unity. The same idea can be applied in any engine with Spine runtime support, like Unreal, so be sure to check it out. Thank you for following along. I hope you found this useful. Don't forget, a link to this Spine file is available to download in the description. Be sure to like and subscribe so you won't miss our next update. We also have other game dev tutorials about spine animation in Unity and our games devlog series, so we'll be happy if you check it out. Until next time.